Alright.
Basics of what is guidance and how to distinguish guidance from other things. And so basically, guidance is what exists before thought, before an idea, before a belief, before a concept. It's something that instinctually and intuition, through intuition, exists before physically created into something else. So, it could come as a little nudge, or a glimpse, or a word, or even an idea before physically an idea thought about. And if that is taken and used, leads to whatever else is there, energetically. And that's why I find speaking through, directly through that felt guidance, initiates a different type of communication that is, it doesn't always make sense, but in terms of the guidance received, but if actually brought into awareness and used physically in reality, will make sense then, more or less. And I just find that ideas and beliefs about what someone needs to do in terms of pros and cons, that has its place, but really, honestly, the answers to whatever you're looking for is basically within you. It's before we think about it. It's before the pros and cons and lefts and rights and ups and downs and backs and forths. Because it's what exists before it's physically taken and made into a complex form. For me, just the act of asking, you know, what is the guidance? Okay, it's there in one way or form or another. You know, just write it down, do what you have to do to retain it, to clear the space that exists between thought and guidance. Because in the stillness, it doesn't need to be thoughts, doesn't need to be any engagements in that way. And without those engagements and beliefs, one can let the guidance come through. And letting the guidance come through is generally a good thing, I would think. I would know. But, yeah, that's basically a short summary of what guidance is.